Leaders are not born. They are made, and they are shaped by their environment, by the people that they meet, and by the events that they encounter. I know that this Presidential Scholars Initiative will inspire a new generation of leaders and to develop them into even greater leaders for the future.
I also think leaders are made. You may have some innate abilities you're born with, but giving people access to inside skills and training, and also literally helping them to keep their heads on straight, is very, very important. And I think there are ways to do that that are quite effective, and I hope we can be helpful to a lot of people.
Here we want people from all walks of life. We want people who have shown the capacity to succeed. And, you know, we just want to be a little extra fuel. People are going to be able to say when they finish this program, I learned a lot about leadership when I studied the presidencies of the four people that are associated with the program. They'll say, wow, I think I can do more.
You all are coming together in support of a great program, which will, I think, be terrific for the country, both for the substance of what it's going to teach some new leaders, but also for what it will say to the country.
The program is the Presidential Leadership Scholars Program. Our objective was to fully use the experience of the presidents so that people who really want to make a difference to the world could learn from them, form a community, and contribute to society.
LBJ realized the need for great leaders in this country. He would also recognize the great leadership qualities in Clinton and the two Bush presidents. That's one of the reasons I'm so excited about this program, because young leaders are coming into our institutions to learn the lessons from these presidents in order to shape a better America.
This is a program that is targeted at people who have demonstrated some capability in leadership and demonstrated a desire and a passion for applying their skills to some public good.
You know, whether they're in private business or they work for their local government or state agency, or they're involved in a nonprofit, or they're in the military, we're not looking for people who share the same perspective on an issue.
We want to create leaders who can learn from the presidents, but the presidents as people. These are human beings who have probably faced a lot of uncertainty in their own minds and yet had to soldier ahead, make decisions, motivate other people when they were probably feeling down and crushed themselves. If they really want to make a difference, you're going to have to go through that. I think that can be inspiring.
There are a lot of people who would like to be president. There are a lot of people who would like to be called the leader. But there are very few people who actually have the will to be the leader and to accept the responsibilities, the obligation, the pressure that comes with being the leader.
The tough decisions are never the black and white decisions. The tough decisions are always the ones that get really into shades of gray. Each individual leader needs to find his or her niche and use what skills they have to affect the outcomes that they are trying to achieve. So we hope to give them the tools with this program to be able to decide on those shades of gray.
We have something very unique in a program that pairs four presidential centers together that really tell the story of some very, very consequential issues. And it just made sense that they come together and help steward this next generation of young, civically inclined Americans. Who better to nurture young leaders than leaders themselves?
Our faith as a nation and our future as a people rests not upon one citizen, but upon all citizens.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order.
What should our shared values be? Everybody counts. Everybody deserves a chance. Everybody's got a responsibility to fulfill. We all do better when we work together.
One of the guiding principles of my presidency was to whom much is given, much is required. And America is such a blessed nation that I believe we have an obligation. Life is service till the end.